Majid, one quick question also from you. You know, every time we report something as far as the governmental action against Maoist goes, there is always a little bit of a problem, whether be it the gunning down of Azad, again, whether be it this whole Binayak Sen case, every time there is a bit of a problem. You know, it's not only the question of justice being done, but also being seen as being done. It's the opposite here. We're not seeing justice being done.
No, absolutely. You see, people should be satisfied. After all, this whole administration of justice functions for the benefit of the people of this country who are supreme. We, the people of India, are the ultimate, you know. Now, therefore, justice must not only be done, as we say, justice must appear to have been done. And I'm sure that this is just a finding of a learned session judge. There are umpteen number of cases where the trial court's verdict are reversed by the appellate court. So let us hopefully see what went wrong, how the charges were upheld, how the conviction has been upheld. All this is going to be examined by the High Court, and I think justice will ultimately be done. Let us
have a Bravo Rao, you're optimistic no that problem. At least in this case, the victory would be of the person who might be downtrodden, poor, not powerful, but at least the voice of the people would be heard in this case.
No, that is not the point here. The problem is, already Vinayak Sen has gone undergone 2 years imprisonment since he did not get bail till the Supreme Court. Now, because it is a life imprisonment, to get a bail, even if he appeals to the higher court, certainly he appeals. But even if he appeals to the higher court, getting a bail is a difficult thing. And you say that you punish a person without a reason for so long a time, and then you say that there is a chance for appeal. That means it is the violating of the human dignity and also his right to liberty. And if this court functions this way, that you can accuse anything, anybody, you can make anybody guilty and put him in jail, put him in bar for years together, and then say that you have got an appeal, you have got a chance to appeal. It is atrocious to play on the liberty of the people.
One final word from Medha Patkar. Medha, you've worked a lot in Dantewada. I know that. I've seen you work there. Is there a problem, particularly in the Chhattisgarh government? Should we say that, let's not talk about India being blamed internationally. The state government had a problem with him, and that's why they put him behind bars.
Of course, the BJP government in Chhattisgarh that brought in this Black Act in the name of Jana Suraksha Adhiniyam of 2005 has the vicious strategy and conspiracy to kill these movements of the Adivasis and their supporters against the grab of the land and the minerals. It is for sure. And I don't know why Chidambaram is supporting this through the joint forces. If the UPA is going ahead with BJP, it is only because they all have the same development paradigm and the policy in favor of the corporates. Hence, the state government needs to be blamed. But the UPA government, now it is their test, because 644 villages are already vacated and lakhs of people are already homeless and landless and livelihoodless. And Vinayak Sen was just opposing Salwa Judum. And hence the BJP government is taking this revenge. I think this is no justice. This is blot on democracy.
All right, Medha Patkar, I'd have to just wrap it up there. Completely affected. Running out of time here. Thank you all, gentlemen, and Medha Patkar for joining us here on Center Stage. Very clearly, this debate is far from over, but at least the public has completely raised its arm of revolt.